Right.
That sheet that you've just got is a sheet on more complex circuit diagrams. They don't look too complicated. Some of them get fairly complicated. My advice to you in each of those cases is always, whether you are asked to do so or not, if it is possible, I'm not saying you must always do it first because it's not always possible to do it first, but in all circuit diagrams, if possible, always try and calculate the current, the main current, first. Once you've got that, everything else is a lot easier. Okay? So do number one, please, or number 25 as it's listed there. Right. Okay, is there anyone who's not yet finished number one or number 25? Right, who'd like to tell me how to do it, please? Hands up. Right, Dylan? Yes. So in other words, if there had been a voltmeter here, I'm not saying there is, I'm going to go and put in an additional voltmeter. Okay, you're entitled to add any voltmeters if you want to, or any meters if you want to. What would that voltmeter be reading? 4 volts. How would you get that? 12 for the whole circuit. That's already getting 8, so that means 4 left for that one. Yes, okay. Then what would you do? Okay, so you just said straight 2 ohms. You could see that the ratio of volts to ohms, 4 volts for every 1 ohm, so that must be 2 ohms. I'm happy to accept that. Any other ways of doing it with a formula? What did I say was always the first thing you should try and do? Now, obviously, the first thing you had to do was work that out, but who could try and come up with another suggestion? What did I say was the first thing you must try and calculate? Current. I equals V over R. Now, let's just stop and have a look. You've got a V there, you've got a V there, and you've got a V there. You've got an R there, and you've got an unknown R there. Which V and which R is that? Who's not sure about that? Okay, the thing is, you've always got to match your voltage and your resistance or your current. When we're dealing with these three formulas, just write it up here. This formula I equals V over R. The V, the I, the R, they've always got to go together. I can't just match any of them up. So where do I have a voltage and a resistance at the same place? Can I take that voltage and that resistance? Why not? They don't apply to the same resistor, do they? Can I take that voltage and that resistance? Can I take that resistance and that voltage? Yes. So V would be 4 over 1 gives me 4 amps. So what did I say I can add as many of if I want to? Meters. If I had an ammeter there, what would the reading on that ammeter be? 4 amps. Okay. Now, can I calculate this resistance? Okay. R equals V over I. What V am I going to use? Which I am I going to use? Which resistance am I trying to find? That resistance. So which V must I use? That 8. I can't use that 4 or that 12. So I must use the 8. Now, I must use the current that flows through here. What's the current that flows through there? That 4 amps flows through there as well? Yes. Gives me an answer of? Simple. So whether you did it by ratio and proportion, or whether you calculated I first and then R, no problem. I would suggest you take down both methods. Because especially in the test or an exam, if it says show all calculations, you can't just use the ratio and proportion method then. Can't do it in your head. When you're finished taking that down, I'd like you to do number 26, please. Sorry? Let me have a look on mine. Yes, that is 18 volts. Doesn't come out very clear, I'm afraid. Next week, grade 11s, I will be giving you a test, okay? On Monday, you'll write a test, okay? On Tuesday, I'll leave you a worksheet, and on Wednesday, I'll leave you a worksheet, and possibly on Thursday, I will see you. What time do I see you on Thursday next week? It's week one, is it? Which day? Which lesson? After break. So there's a good chance I will see you. Okay. Next week I'm unfortunately away this weekend and until Thursday at a ISASA principals conference in Port Elizabeth. So therefore Monday you'll have a test, and the test will be on all the electricity we do up till the end of tomorrow. Okay? In other words, today's stuff, all of that. And then I will leave you with worksheets or questions that you'll do on Tuesday, Wednesday, and possibly Thursday if I'm not back. Right? Now apply the same methodology. Now, if you look at these circuit diagrams, they don't look too complex, do they? I mean, this number 25, it's probably more complicated than any of the others you've done so far this year. But some of the others look pretty complex. Number 25, often the simpler the circuit diagram, the more complicated it is. And these ones that are filled with meters and readings and all of that are actually quite easy to do. You just do them bit by bit. Time. I normally panic when I see the simple ones that don't have much in it. They can be tricky. Right, is everyone finished with number 26? Is there anyone who's not yet finished? Okay. Remember, as I said, you can add in any extra meters that you want to. That's up to you. That's fine. Right, Puleng, you tell me how to do number 18, please. Sorry? You don't think you've got the right answer? Okay, well, tell me what you've done. And I expect everyone to pay attention, please. Jonathan? Could do that, but it doesn't really. What does say is the first thing you should always try and do? Well, let's work on the current if you can. Which I and which R and which V are you going to use? Can you, if you use that V, which R must you use? That one? That one? That one? These two together, all three together. Can anyone tell me, if you want to use the formula I equals V over R, and you use the 18 volts, which is the voltage for the whole circuit, isn't it? That's what's available for the whole circuit. Okay, which resistor should you use now? Micah? These two. One. And you'd use that answer. What about this resistor? Is that not part of the circuit? Does this battery not feed this resistor and these two? So you've got, yeah. Yes, so. Then you could work out that one's resistance. Could you? No. That doesn't help. Luto? 2 ohms and the 6 amps, how would you work out which current where? Everywhere in a series circuit. Is this a series circuit? So is the current the same there as there? Is the current the same there as there? Doesn't this branch of current match up and meet up with the 6 amps and add up together? So this current there will be greater than that current there. So, Micah? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. So if I had to put a fictitious ammeter there, you're saying it would read? 3 ohms, I think it would be 3 amps. Okay, right, so we know, do you all agree that that would be 3 amps? Who doesn't get that? Hands up. I want to see who's not with me. Who doesn't get why that's 3 amps? Explain why, Pauline? So it will get 2 times more current, 2 times less current. Okay, can I put another ammeter anywhere else, Nikita? Where? So like over here, what would that ammeter read? What? Possibly B? What do you want to make it? Where do you get 9 from? 6 and 3. You want to make that 9. Who agrees with her? If you turn back in your notes, you'll certainly see on page 14. Have a look at all of those exercises, people. Didn't you go home and go through your work yesterday? If you don't, you're going to get left behind. Okay, so now we know that the current here is 9 amps. We've still got to go further. 9 amps isn't going to help us get that resistance. Shock? Where? So if I go, you want to go and put a voltmeter over this whole parallel setup here. Couldn't I just put a voltmeter over one of the parallel resistors? Why not? But isn't the voltage on that resistor the same as the voltage on that resistor, the same as the voltage over both resistors together? You could. So could I put a voltmeter here? What would that voltmeter's formula be? IR, what is I? That's flowing through there. 3. What is R? What is my voltage there? 12 volts. What would my voltage here be? 12 volts. What would this voltmeter be reading? 12 volts. If I had to put a voltmeter here, what would it read? Total voltage for the whole circuit, minus 12 volts is used here, leaves me with 6 volts. Who didn't get that? Okay, they do get a little bit more complex. Now, as I say, you're not going to be able to do them if you don't go home and go through your work. Grade 11s, there's only one way to get this, and this is to graph through it and work. Oh, sorry, you're trying to work out the resistance. How are you going to do that, Christopher? R equals V over I. What is the voltage here? No, it's not. Yeah. You're trying to find this resistor, so you need this voltage. What's the 6? What is the current that's flowing through there? 9 equals 2 over 3 ohms. You did the total resistance for the circuit. Okay, so you did R total equals V total over I total. What's the voltage that's total for the whole thing? 18. What's your total current? What's your total resistance? 2 ohms. Then you worked out this combined resistance. And what did that combined resistance give you? We'll call it R parallel. 4 over 3 ohms. Therefore, you said R, well, let's call it little r, okay? So you've worked out what the total resistance is, 2. This resistance, 4 over 3. Therefore, R equals R total minus R parallel equals 2 minus 4 over 3 gives me 2 over 3 ohms. Two possible ways of doing it. Okay, who's a little bit lost and panicky now? Can I just show you what the next lot are? When we get to internal resistance. Internal resistance means that the batteries also have a resistance automatically built into them. And you've got to take that into account. So that when you close the switch and current starts flowing, your voltmeter reading drops down. That will drop down to about 17, 16 and a half. Okay, so you've got lost volts. And now it gets a little bit more complex. Grade 11s, this is easy work. If you go home and make sure you know your past notes pat off, back to front. If you don't, you are going to be horribly lost. This is a section of work you can either score full marks or naught. Choice is yours. The difference is 2 hours of hard work, going over and over and over your examples, even the same examples, go over them. And go over them until suddenly you realize, oh, now I see why he uses that voltage and not that voltage. Now I understand why he's using that resistance and not that resistance. Okay, I would like you to do number 27 now, please. You got it? Another 2 minutes. This one that you're on at the moment, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 marks. Number 27, 7 marks. Three for calculating that. One for calculating that voltage, and then another 3. Okay, let's start marking. Okay, pay attention please. If we have a look at this circuit, we're asked to calculate this resistance here. That's one of the things we've got to do, and that voltage there. Okay, now that voltage is a nice easy one. That's simple. We're just going to go straight to our formula for voltage, V equals IR. Do you agree? Now, if I'm calculating that voltage, which current must I use? I must use the current that's flowing through there. Is that the same as that 5 amps? Yes. So it's 5 amps. Okay. Times. If I'm calculating that voltage, which resistance must I use? That. Any others? I use that resistance. So this is going to be 10 volts. Now, stop now and just listen or think. How much voltage has that battery got available for the circuit? 22. How much of the battery's voltage is being used here? So where else has that battery got to spend voltage? Does it spend any there? Does it spend any here? How much is it going to spend on this portion? This whole lot, yeah, if I had to put a voltmeter over that whole thing there, what would it read? 12 volts. Do you all agree with that? Okay. Now, if the voltage over the whole thing is 12 volts, what's the voltage over this little bit here? Also 12 volts. Can I calculate that? I'm not so sure if I can. If I was going to say R equals V over I, can I? Oh yes, I've got there. So I can say R equals V over I. What is voltage? Which voltage do I use? 10, 22, or 12? 12, which eye do I use? 5 or 2? 2 gives me. So that, 6 ohms, my apologies. So that is 6 ohms, you've calculated everything. Okay, was that too difficult? Right, homework number 28 and 29 for tomorrow, please. 28 and 29, but that's not all. Make sure that certainly up to number 27 you can do with your eyes closed. Even if I give you variations of it, make sure you can do up to number 27 and all the notes beforehand that you understand it back to front. So your homework is not just doing 28 and 29. In fact, I'm going to relent. Homework, just 28. But you'd better make sure that you understand everything. Because tomorrow in class, I'm going to give you 10 minutes to do 29. Then we're covering internal resistance. If we don't finish internal resistance tomorrow, I've got to cover it before I leave, because that's the work for next week. You come back on Friday afternoon or Saturday morning to finish internal resistance. So that means you've got to know your work. Okay? Thank you.